today's video, we're going to look at the TV and DVD player that we've got in the main cab here. Hopefully you'll be out enjoying yourself and on the beach, but there are going to obviously be occasions where you may want to sit down and catch up with the news or watch a movie. Okay, so the TV is released down into its watching position by releasing this this lever here. Just turn it 90 degrees and that will bring the TV down. Now, at the moment, the van has got no power. Normally you probably would have already have the 12 volt turned on, but I'm just going to show you how to turn on the 12 volt. So if we just come up to this panel up above the door here, and you'll see this button here, and that now has made the 12 volt live in the van. So we turn into the TV. There's a switch on the top here. Clearly says on off, so you know where you are. Put that on and you'll see the red light come on there. Now the remote control for the television is normally stored in this cupboard here, and we won't use that just yet because I just need to show you first, before we can use the TV we need to raise the antenna and we also need to tune the TV in. So before we can watch the TV, obviously we need an antenna that's tuned in, so I'm now going to show you how to do that. In the main cupboard here, just behind these two drawers, so if I open them up, they're quite stiff, but once you've got them open, you can see in the cupboard here, we've got the main antenna itself here, and up on the wall there is the power for the antenna. So we reach over, and it's a bit of a stretch, but on the top here is the on-off button. Now, the antenna has to be tuned in, and I'll just show you how to do that. So there's a release on the top here. We undo that and then push up the antenna to its highest position. Now once it's up there, and you can see if, and I'll put a little in-video picture here that you can also see, when you rotate the main tube here, on the digital antenna it will change from red, orange to green. So obviously what we're looking for is a green light, which gives us the maximum potential tuning. So you can just see it's going to orange now and now to green. So that's where we want it. Push it up to its maximum and tighten up this little screw here which holds it in place. So the TV is now in the lowered position and the antenna is raised, and we've got the antenna pointing in the right direction to get the best signal. So the next step is to actually tune the TV in, and this must be done every time you arrive in a new place. The tuning in one area will not be the same when you get to your next location, so always remember when you put it on for the first time, aerial or antenna up, and then tune in the TV. So I'm just going to press power on the remote control here. I always find that the sensor for the remote control is on the top here, so if you keep this low down it tends not to work so well. So I just raise it up a little bit higher, and there's a light on the top here that will go blue, and that shows that the TV is now on, as you can see. On the remote control here there's two setup buttons, one for the TV, one for the DVD. Obviously we want the TV, and using the arrow keys here, once I've selected the TV setup, I'm just going to come down to the channel selection, and using the right arrow key just go across to auto search. Pressing the OK on that, we're in New Zealand, and press OK, and now the TV will basically find all the channels that are available in your area. Now, New Zealand obviously is can have quite a few remote areas, so you may find that when you get to a particular place, if it is remote, the TV may not pick up a decent signal. We found that in most big towns the TV works pretty well, so you can get your evening viewing or the news or whatever it is you want to watch. This particular TV also has a DVD player in it, inbuilt, and we haven't tested it fully yet in terms of regions, but you're welcome to bring your own DVDs, movies and so on, and play these on the TV. It may be a good time to do that when maybe you haven't got a TV signal but you still want to have a bit of evening's entertainment. The slot for the DVD is just around the side here. I think basically all you need to do is to pop your DVD in there, and the TV should auto detect that a DVD has been put in and start playing. Now, when you finish with the TV and you're maybe heading off on a journey the next day, it's very important to remember that the antenna that might have been up from the night before needs to be lowered. So I'll just quickly show you how to do that. So back in the cupboard here, we undo the screw at the top here, allowing the antenna to drop down. Now you have to feel it down slowly, because the space on the roof for it is limited. So I've just found the sweet spot there. It just comes all the way down. Sometimes you'll find that if it's on an angle, it will hit maybe the solar panel on the roof there, but it's that there's a good spot for it. In fact, there's a little indicator on here which is used when in certain countries the antenna might need to be in the vertical plane rather than the horizontal. Here I found it works in the horizontal. This is what this is for, is to turn the antenna from horizontal to vertical, but I haven't found the need to do that here, so I don't think you need to worry about that. But basically that little window there, when it's pointing in that direction, that's the best location for having the antenna fully down. So once it's in the fully down position, just tighten that up again. And finally, whilst we're in here, remember to turn off the amplifier up there. So we've returned the antenna to its safe position for driving. Now all we have to do basically is to put the TV away. So to do that, we just raise it up, and as I mentioned earlier, the clip here is quite a squeeze to get it into place, so you have to use a little bit of force to get it up into position, and I'm struggling as we speak. There we go. So as you can see, it does require a little bit of effort to get that into place, but that's basically locked now, in position, ready for moving off. That's the end of this particular video. We hope it's been useful. Check out our other handover videos on YouTube. To find us, just search for NZ Camper to Go, and remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you're sure to get any updates or new videos that we add from time to time. That's NZ Camper, the number 2 and Go. You can also check out our Facebook page by searching for the same name. And if you'd like to like our page, that would also be great. If you've got any suggestions of how we can improve the information we're providing here, you can email that to us at nzcamper2go@gmail.com. Thanks again for watching, and goodbye for now.